out, I've got a thumbs up already, and we've only just started the live stream. So come on, who's in here? Oh, my roots need doing. We got coffee tonight, guys. You can't beat a coffee. It looks like the clowns are trying to swim into it. Hey, Amanda, how's it going? Welcome to my live stream. Except for my coffee cup blocking the view, of course. There you go. It's a bit better. Hey, Sandy, how's it going? How's this fish room? Yo, how's it going? How's it going, Sandy? How's your week been going? I've got some news for everyone, but I'm going to wait for a few people to come in before I give away the news. Any updates on the new tank, says Blake? No, the new tank's not getting set up until May the 8th when I move house. Hey, Pabs, welcome to the live stream. See, I told you I'd be on at 8 o'clock. Give you time to get the baby in bed and do what you need to do. Get your shower and that. I am having a coffee today. There's no Coke today. I'm having a coffee. Whoa, my fucking screen's just gone blue. Sandy's still fighting the flu bug. Oh, I feel sorry for you, I do. Why has my screen just suddenly gone blue? Is everybody else seeing blue? It looks kind of cool. I think I need to get my glasses changed. Oh, you'll have to excuse me because I'm drinking this coffee as fast as I can. Thank you, Sandy. Oh, there you go. It's gone normal again. I think my phone's a bit broke. It's got to be. Because that definitely looked blue a minute ago and now it looks nice and colourful again. Sandy, take a look at my frags. I'm going to give you a close-up now. They're doing really well. They're all standing up and they're all nice and pink. And I'm going to frag this one in a minute, this big one here, this Kenya tree, because it's leaning over and that one looks nice and tidy and that one's leaning over. And some good news. I don't know if everybody's subscribed to Mad Dog's Reef. Well, he is sending me something really cool in the post. So in exchange, I'm going to give him a couple of frags. So I'm going to sort him out some Kenya trees. So yeah, it's going to be really cool. It's going to be the first time that I've fragged something and sent it to somebody. So I'm a bit nervous about it, but hopefully it should go okay. Oh, the reason why we've got no one in here is because Rico is live. And I think CJ is going live as well. So maybe that's why we've got no people in here tonight. Thank you. Yeah, I like my Kenya trees. They're really colourful. Young Tank says it's too early because he's still at work. Yeah, because it's probably about 12 o'clock for you, isn't it, Young Tank? Pab says to hell with them because he's here. Yeah, exactly. It's always a party with Pabs in the room. Always a party. Well, while the room fills up and I drink my lovely coffee, I am going to finish my picnic. Mmm, I love picnics. See, it's gone blue again. Every time I put something in front of the screen, it changes colour. Now it's making a liar out of me now. Ah, there you go, it's back to normal now. So I'm going to stop putting things in front of my camera. I think my camera's broke. Mmm. But I'm getting a new phone soon, so hopefully the quality should be a lot better. I shouldn't eat and talk at the same time, should I? It's really rude. Talking with your mouth full. Oh, right, it's only dinner time in Cali. Shit, you're like 8 hours behind. I could tell you your future. Shame I can't tell you the lottery numbers. I had this talk the other day with Sandy. No, I'm not eating while I'm talking because that's just feel really rude. Right, who wants to know my news? I've got to tell somebody. Because I've had a really sad day today. The packing is going great. I have done so much and I've thrown so much away. I've still got 3 weeks to go. And I've done everything, so I've got nothing to do now. Haz's fish room says it's 4 a.m. where he is. Whereabouts are you, Haz? Are you in China or somewhere like that? Or Malaysia or Thailand or somewhere really cool? I feel really honoured that you're actually awake at 4 a.m. and you're watching my live stream. That's really cool. So as soon as we get to 10 people in here, I'll tell you my news. And I want to see 10 people and I want to see 10 likes. So get hitting that thumbs up, everybody. As soon as I hit 10 likes, I'll tell you my news. And it's quite sad. So I hope you're all braced. You've got your tissues at the ready because it is quite sad update. And I don't want no haters and I don't want no one. Somebody gave me a thumbs down, really. I have a hater in here, that's awesome. Yeah, Pabs, you go and tell them. I was going to title it PB Goes Naked, but no. That was a bit clickbaity, wasn't it? Oh, you're going to work now, Haz, at 4 a.m. in the morning. Where do you work? Do you work in like a bakery or something like that? Because they usually start early, don't they? Right, we've got 5 likes. Yeah, no haters while Sandy's got hold of that wrench. Because believe me, if she's going to hit you with it, she's going to hit you with it hard. So be warned. This bitch bites. I'm only kidding. So come on, where is everybody? Maybe. Maybe if we focus on somebody who is just absolutely adorable. Should we spin you around? No, you're not going to look at me. Look at you all getting excited. I haven't done my hair or anything, so you're not going to be looking at me. Let's look at Major. There he is. There's my baby. My big baby boy. He is absolutely adorable, isn't he? And it's him right there, who made us make the decision that we've made today. And it was a hard decision to make. Hey, Miss Saltwater, Miss Saltwater's in the house. Woo, Pabs, what did you do to get Miss Saltwater in here? Ah, see, Pabs is on the ball. Pabs is on the ball. Yeah, you know what I've done, don't you, Pabs? I had to do it. It was inevitable because Major is my baby. He is fully house trained. He is an excellent guard dog. He is the softest, most lovable dog that you would ever meet. And when you get a puppy, you really don't think that it's going to cause the chaos that it's going to cause. Nelson decided that he didn't like Major very much and they ended up fighting. Now, it wasn't very pleasant, it wasn't very nice. Major's got a damaged eye, so I had to rehome Nelson. So Nelson, I'm afraid, is not with us anymore. Miss Saltwater, how old is he? Major's 3 and a half. And he is a big softy. Now, I'll try and get a close-up and we'll have a look at his eye and see if he can see it. Come here. Come here. Come. Come. I will, Mum. I don't know if he's seeing that. But his eye is pretty... So, and look how red his ears are. That's because of the puppy. So now he can actually relax. He can come in the house, he can sit where he wants to sit and be nice and relaxed without having to worry about the puppy constantly attacking him. Now, when I say this puppy was attacking him, it was proper attacking him. Now, Major's really, really well behaved. He's that well behaved that he didn't react to any of it. But when you've got a 16-month-old puppy hanging off your big dog's eye and it's refusing to let go, there's not really much you can do. Now, we've had these problems with him for the past couple of weeks. We have tried, believe me, we have tried. But, yeah, things just didn't work out, and I thought it was cruel on Major because he was always getting locked into the little kitchen. Obviously, he still had access to the whole of the garden, but he wasn't allowed in the house because every time he come in the house, the puppy would literally just dive on him, and it just wasn't fair on him. So I found this nice lady, and she's really nice, and she's took Nelson, and they've got a bearded dragon. Now, she's just sent me a video of Nelson meeting this bearded dragon, and it is the cutest video ever, and she's given me permission to upload it onto my channel. So when this live stream finishes, about 9:30, I will upload it to YouTube so you can all check it out. But I will be getting regular updates on him, and yeah, so it's sad, but it just had to happen. Now, Miss Saltwater Tank said, what breed of dog was Nelson? Well, Nelson, when I got him, when he was advertised as an American Bulldog, now Major's an American Bulldog, but when I went to see his parents, the dad was an American Bulldog, but the mum was a Pitbull. Now, I think the puppy had more Pitbull in him than American Bulldog, hence the very severe lockjaw that he's got. So, I did what I had to do, and I've made the right decision. And yeah, it was sad to see him go, but he was so happy. And yeah, so fingers crossed everything works out okay. And I do, I miss him a little bit, but not as much as what I thought, because Major's my baby. So hey Kevin, how's it going? Oh, you've put me off trail now, completely off trail. I've forgotten what I was talking about. What was I talking about? Coffee. CJ, why are you in here? I thought you were doing a live stream. I forgot what I was talking about now. See, you just like completely. Miss Saltwater says that I did make the right decision. It's sad, but you did the right thing. And she's glad that Major's happy again. Yeah, I am glad that I made the decision that I made, Miss Saltwater, because honestly, seeing your big dog just getting bullied was just wrong. Bubba thought... No, that was clickbait, Bubba. Hey, what's happening, Doctor of Welsh? Glad you could make it. I did try to make it at a time that, like, all the wives would be watching soaps. So I thought they could all jump in here and join in my live stream. Yeah, it's a real pleasure to have you in here with us, Louise, because, yeah, you are the star of this live stream. You really are. I think everyone enjoys watching your videos, and I especially enjoy watching your Australian vlog. You definitely, definitely should do more vlogs, because they are, they're really cool to watch. Hey, Rico's in the house. What's up, Rico? Oh, don't tell me you ended your live stream just to come and see mine. Because I've already given out all the news. Everybody knows the news now, except for yous. Yeah, everybody missed the show. No, how can I be the star of this live stream? All you're listening to is my voice. Yeah, it'd be different if it was a live stream like Rico's, where everyone could join in. That'd be really cool. I'll probably do one of them one night. Definitely. Oh, Bubba, you're so sweet. You really are. Apparently, I've been hit up by quite a few people who want my voice in their videos. I feel quite proud of that. I do. Really proud of it. Miss Saltwater, Louise, I need your email address. If you can possibly email me, my email's in the description in all of my videos. If you could email me with your email address, I'm doing a video for somebody and it's regarding females, and I would really, really, really love your take on something. So if you could email me and then I've got your email address, I can reply and let you know what the plan is. And if you want to get involved, you're more than welcome to. It'd be an honour, actually, to have you to take part. But it's a girly thing, so yeah, just email me, please. If you can't find my email, it's skunky-monkeylive@hotmail.co.uk. So yeah, just hit me up with an email. Right, what can we talk about now? My coffee's going cold. Pouts, you can't help, you're not female. I want PB's voice on my GPS. Yeah, please turn left. Please turn right. No, I don't think I'd be very good at that. I actually had my voice feature in one of Pet Tech's videos. That was kind of cool. He sent me a script and I had to say what he was doing, and I felt really stupid talking to my phone and saying these phases that he wanted me to say. But it turned out good in the end. Ah, okay, Louise is using the data on the phone, so she can't stay long. That's cool, Louise. I'm just glad that you eventually came in and caught me on live stream. Hey, Mad Cypress is in the house. What's up, Lorenzo? Happy 420. Everybody have a happy 420. Apparently it's the 420 day. Everyone hit the like button or get blocked. Yeah, come on CJ, get everyone liking my video. I forgot that I gave you that wrench. You said you didn't want it. I can take it away if you don't want it, if you don't like it, but I think it suits you. Okay, what did Dave say? Because everyone's laughing. Okay, E-Money's in the house. Squad up. DeAndre's talking to himself over there. Laugh out loud. Oh, have you left him over there talking? Oh, that's so cool. All right, Louise, thanks for joining. I love you loads, and I'll speak to you soon. Definitely coffee time. Definitely coffee time. E-Money's my brother. He's not your brother, Dave. Is he? Yeah, definitely. Definitely 420. Definitely. Ah, okay. Your brother from another mother. CJ, it's 420 every day here in the UK. You're not the only ones, you know. We know how to wrap it up here in the UK. Don't worry. I've seen you before with your snazzy cigar. Coffee. Best thing ever. Yes, it's just over the river and through the hood. All good in the hood. Well, she says, gotta go and check on my newbies and do some video editing. Oh, good luck with that, Welshie. Yeah, I'll bring it in a minute. I haven't had a chance to check out your videos yet. I'm still going through my list. So, yeah. Me talk Welsh, Dave. You having a giggle? I can't talk Welsh. I can't talk Welsh at all. Somebody's going to wreck next door's front door if he doesn't put his drill and hammer away. looks like what we call cachito, which is cocoa milk and liqueur. Mmm, that sounds nice. Yeah, you gotta get your kids first, Lorenzo. Definitely gotta get your kids first. Or you'll be doing a 420 and you forget about them. CJ, what's new in the tank? What's new in the tank? Let's have a look. I attacked my Kenya tree and I did a couple of frags off it. They look quite cool. They're growing nice and they're opening up as well. I was quite pleased. And I fragged that and it's now opening up. It looks really good. Tonk. I don't say tonk. I say tank. Tank. It's tank. You know, we're not going to have an English lesson, are we really, on a live stream? I heard Rico say yogurt before and I just couldn't stop laughing because we don't say yogurt, we say yogurt. It's a yogurt. And we don't say aluminium, we say aluminium. So yeah, I don't know about yogurt. That, like, it just made me laugh. Hey, Super Yellow Tank, how's it going? Super Yellow Tank, I am keeping you to your word. This bad boy here, let's have a look, spin you around. This bad boy here is getting set up as a reef tank on the 8th of May. So make sure you're all around then for the 8th of May. Because it's going to be great. I can't wait. I've got all my rock. I've got all my sand. I've got a background. I've got something special coming from Mad Dog. And oh, it's going to be amazing. I can't wait. I can't wait to get in my new house. I can't wait to get a garden. Promise is a promise. Yeah, I'll definitely keep you to it. And yeah, I'll have loads of videos up of me setting it up and what I'm doing with it. So make sure you check them out. Aluminium is the proper way. Yes. Hello, Liverpool. Yay. Yes, it is the right way of saying it. It's the proper way of saying it. Hey, Scouse in the house. Hey, I can talk Scouse now because Danny's in here. He'll know exactly what I'm talking about. He'll understand me perfectly. 3 days after our lass's birthday, I'll just start her in front of the device and you say, happy birthday, Kim. Happy birthday. Well, let's have a look. Double streaming is above my skill level, says Dave. Dave, nothing is above your skill level. Honestly, you are the streaming king. What fish am I going to put in the new tank, says Armando. I really do not know. I really, really do not know. I've got a really shitty fish shop by me. And it really doesn't stock the nicest of fish. So it's going to be a bit difficult for me to get fish, which is what's going to make it all the more exciting. So I guess if you want to know what fish I'm going to be putting in it, you're just going to have to stay tuned. See you later, Welshie. Take it easy. I'll check your videos out tonight. Definitely, definitely, definitely. Right, I've got 18 people in here and I've only got 13 thumbs up. So if you don't want CJ banning you, you need to give the video a thumbs up. We need to tally up. We need 18 and 18. So I know 5 of you haven't pushed that thumbs up. 4. We'll make it 4. Okay, now it's only 2. I think that my shrimp is going to molt. Now the reason why I'm saying this is because he is hiding behind that rock over there. Now when he hides behind that rock, it means that he's gonna shred his skin. CJ says he's about to be whack a troll in a minute. You always get love from me. Thumbs up always. Love is love. Totally agree with you, Money. Squad up. I love that saying. I really do. I say it to my kids and they look at me and they go, Mum, you are crazy. Yeah, I like my thumbs. Yes, I do. There you go. We really like to see those thumbs. CJ, Pabs isn't a troll. Yeah, please, please, please don't ban Pabs. Please don't. The same goes out to everybody in my live chat that's got a wrench. Please do not ban Pabs. Honestly. Yeah, positive. Absolutely positive. Pabs is a pisser. No, seriously, do not ban Pabs. Don't. All right, catch you in a bit, Lorenzo. Coral on the bottom left is a feather. Bottom left. Right, I don't know. Are you on about this big pink thing here? I don't know. I think it's a leather. Sandy, you know what it's called. What's it called? I am absolutely shit with my coral's names. Yeah, we've got to leave Pabs in here. Pabs is the only reason I come online. He is, because he just makes me laugh. And he brightens up my day, and he's brilliant. Yeah, my leather. That's my leather, everybody who was asking. Yeah, that's my leather. See, Pabs, I'm showing you my love. Okay. Hey, Becky Smith. Welcome to the live stream. Yeah, I've been told so much about you. And yeah, it's a pleasure to finally meet you. And I will have to come and check out your channel and give you a sub at the same time. Because us girls, as you all know, we stick together. And we're all bitches when we're together. That's Nelson's testicle sack in the tank. No, it's not. Nelson's gone. We don't talk about Nelson now because it's sad. And my coffee's gone cold. So I'm not drinking the rest of that. Yuck. In fact, I've put it in the wrong place because now you can't see nothing. Two sugars and milk. but is it brown sugar or white sugar, Danny? I have brown sugar. And I need a haircut. Really need a haircut. CJ, start a live stream. Don't be so evil, Dave. Don't be so evil. You never know, you might miss something. Hey mate, how's it going? Welcome to the crazy live stream. Right, while I've got you all in here, I'm going to explain this food because I got so many people messaging me, asking me what the food was that I was feeding to the fish the other day. Apparently, no one in US can get it, but I've seen it on the internet and I've lost my little thing. Oh, where's it gone? Oh, I know where it's gone. It's gone down the back of the tank. Oh yeah, it's in my filter. Right. This is what I was feeding them the other day. It's Vitalis Marine Grazer. And you get like the little ring thing that you put on it. And they look like that. And you just stick it to your glass. And the fish love it. So do the snails. So do the shrimp. So that's what it was that I was sticking on the glass the other day in my video when everybody was asking me. I think it was my feeding frenzy. Now it says, and I've got my wrong glasses on, so it just says it generates natural feeding behaviour, basically. I can't read what's in it because I haven't got my reading glasses on. But that's what it is. It's Vitalis Marine Grazer. If you can get it in the US, let me know. Because it is. It's really, really good. And they like it. So make sure you go and check it out. But they do all kinds. They do marine flakes, they do algae flakes, they do marine pellets, and then they do the extra large marine flakes. So should we do a live feed them? Yeah, sub party. Everybody sub everybody else up. Everyone who's not sub to everybody. Because a lot of people that come into my live stream are not salt water. A lot of them are fresh water. So yeah, everybody gets subbing everybody up. Because I think it's important that salt water people watch fresh water people's videos and vice versa. Because if you watch enough salt water videos like I did, you will want to own a salt water tank for definite. I guarantee it. I've got so many people asking me how hard it was to do this tank, and I've got so many people that are now getting the tank and setting a salt water tank up for the first time, which is really, really cool. So that's enough for them, because I definitely do not overfeed anymore, because that's where all my algae issues came into effect. There you go, we had a live feeding. I'm not liking this tripod. This tripod is just pants. It really is. Yeah, everyone sub Super Yellow Tank. Yeah, he's got, yeah, sub him up. E-Money said he's going salt soon. E-Money, if I get chosen for CJ's draw, you know what's going to happen. You already know what's going to happen. So really, you've got a double the chance of winning, because if you win, bonus. If I win, you win. So yeah, that's even cooler. So yeah, sub party. I also need 3 more thumbs. We've only got 17 out of 20. E-Money, look, love is love. It's all about sharing and caring and sharing the love, and there is no better feeling than entering a contest and getting chosen and being able to choose somebody else to give the prize to. It does, it feels really rewarding. So yeah, love is love, definitely is. Yeah, so everybody who's not sub to everybody else that's in here, make sure you sub them all up. And also, if everybody's wondering where the money went for the Billy Pipes campaign, unfortunately, YouTube will not release any of my money until I reach £60. Now, I'm currently struggling. I'm only at £30 at the moment, but the minute it reaches 60 and then funds are released to me, they will be going into the Billy Pipes fund. So everything that I earn on this channel from now until then will all be going to the Billy Pipes Fund. If anybody doesn't know about the Billy Pipes Fund, which you should all know about by now, there is a video on my channel, and I will put the link in the description box below on this video when it finishes. And if anybody else wants to go and check out the GoFundMe page, please do feel free to go and do so. I know most of you in here already have, so I just want to say big, big, huge, super thank you to all of you. I know Billy is absolutely just astonished by all the love that he's getting shown, and yeah, so very, very good. Danny, my monetization in total for all videos, you just reached $8. It's a start, Danny. Honestly, when I first started, I was checking my AdSense constantly, and I found that if you don't watch it, it just automatically goes up. So just keep checking it like every month or something like that, and it'll start going up. What you've got to remember is, Danny, you don't throw out the videos. So there you go. That's what you've got to do. It's the number one thing. It's not just about putting out videos. It's about commenting, replying, and keeping in touch with all your subscribers. Because the more you do that, the more people will come and visit your channel, and the more you'll aim. Now, a lot of people use it to put back into the tank. I'm going to be using mine to be putting back into my channel. So everything that I make on my YouTube channel will always be going back into it. So yeah, it's just a nice little way of getting a little bit extra. And it's, yeah, like you said, Danny, it's a hobby for me. But if you can earn money at the same time doing what you love and enjoy, then why not? Why not? Because tell you what, there's a lot of channels out there learning a hell of a lot more than me, and they are garbage. Yellow Tank says he only has 2 subscribers. Well, one of them's me, and I think the other one is Electric Water. So can everybody please go and subscribe to Super Yellow Tank's channel? You can see his name in the chat now, and just click on it, go to his channel and send him a sub. Let's see if we can get Super Yellow Tank to 100 subs, because that would be really cool. Dave says he's going to use his to buy an iPhone 20. That's where my first check is coming. I don't think it'll be that far away, Dave. No, I doubt it. Pab says, a friend of Lecky Water is a friend of mine. Yeah, everyone likes Electric Water. Talking of the little leprechaun, I wonder where he is. I haven't seen any of my bandits in here tonight, so I don't know where they are. Yeah, he's got quite a few subs coming his way, so yeah, make sure you all sub to him. And the same for Armando as well. Everybody go and sub his channel up, because this is the only way now that people are going to get subs, because it's just so easy and it gets you to know loads more people. Like when you put a video out, you usually only sub to the person's video that you're watching. When you do a live stream like this, you can get so many people in here and get everyone involved and get everyone to know each other. And yeah, it's brilliant. I love it. I love getting a community together. I think it's amazing. And I do have to admit, I did sit here this afternoon pondering whether to do another shout out series. I really was pondering whether to do it or not. So I might leave it for a couple of weeks and I might wait until I've moved house, and then we'll see if I'm up for the ticket of doing it again. Because it was challenging, very challenging. Now I can show you some books, and I've got like 7 books and they're just full of my shout out videos. I've got everyone's names in there and it's crazy. I've even got 2 shout out videos that I did for the Aquarium Tuba Tag Challenge. Did you all guys know that there are still 350 people that have not accepted the Aquarium YouTube Challenge? That is a lot of people. And you know what? I just couldn't keep up with them all. I really couldn't. I was writing page after page after page of all these people's names and channels, and I just couldn't do it anymore. I got to about 150 and I thought, no, I just can't do this anymore. It was just so time consuming, but it was fun, and I'm glad everyone took part who did. It was great. Definitely got the community together, that's for sure. And that was the whole purpose. Right, I need to just go and grab my cigarette off my boyfriend, so give me 1 second. Okay, I'm back. Right, it's not a fag yellow tag. It's 420 day. Come on. That's a horrible word, isn't it? Fag. Why are cigarettes called fags, really? It's a fag. A fag is, and I'm not even going to go into it. I'm not even going to go into what we call them in the UK, because it's going to be quite a controversial video if I do, so no, I'll keep my mouth shut. Yeah, it's a ciggy. Or as we say in Liverpool, it's a bifter. Yeah, Pab's got it right. Oh my God, guess who's in the room? It used to refer to kindling, then I suppose the smoking cigarette seems close enough to keep the title. Then I think someone got creative along the way and put it on gay guys. Hey Jeffy, how's it going? Welcome to my live stream. I don't know what to talk about now. How's that deer coming along? Yeah, aloha. That's what I should have said. I should have greeted you correctly, shouldn't I? I do apologise. It's aloha. I am getting all the stars in tonight, aren't I? Yeah, I do. I feel very privileged tonight. I've had Miss Saltwater Tank in here. I've had CJ in here. I've had Kevin in here. I've had Rico in here. And now I've got Jeff. Jeff B. Jeff, I was going through my videos the other day and I came across the intro that you did for me, and I'm going to start using it again because I really, really enjoyed listening to it again. So yeah, everybody sub up Jeff B, by the way. He's a freshwater keeper and he's got some really nice tanks. So all you saltwater ones in here that haven't had the pleasure of checking out Jeff B's channel, make sure you go and sub to him. Definitely, definitely. I am so hungry. Yay, yeah. Everybody sub everybody else. Right, what Sandy said for Dave to say, my oh my. Rest of my plumbing's just arrived. I should be getting wet soon. You go, girl. Should I ask, is it the first time she's getting wet? Oh, thank you, Jeff. Yeah, I'm glad that when you had the time, you don't. You actually made it to my live stream because the time difference is crazy. And yeah, the tank is looking very, very good. It's going to be such a shame to rip it all down in 3 weeks' time. It is going to be a shame. Dave says he's got to get back to Rico before he takes his frags back. Yeah, that's sound, Dave. You go and join them. Why am I doing that, Jeff? Because I'm moving house. Yes. I'm finally moving on to this caravan that I live in. I call it a caravan because it feels like a caravan. I'm gonna have a bath. I haven't had a bath for 3 years. 3 years, honestly. I've had showers, but I haven't had a bath. And I cannot wait. While they're unpacking all the stuff and bringing all the stuff in, I'm gonna be running a bath. So, yeah. So yeah, that is my first priority when I move. But yeah, it's all happening on the 8th of May. So, really cool. I can't wait. I'm eating Sour Patch Kids. They make them 2 times bigger. You sold your house today, Pabs. Seriously, you sold your house? Why did you do that? Haven't you just decorated and done everything that you've just done to it? You're taking the piss, aren't you? That's what you're doing. You're lying to me. There's no way you sold your house today. The council's going to go nuts on Monday when they find out. Ha Oh, you do, Maya. You are funny. You really are. I can't believe CJ was going to ban you earlier. Honestly. Oh, no, you're just so funny. I actually watched this documentary the other day on Catch Up, and it's about bad tenants and scam landlords or something. And this couple, they put the house up for sale, and they went away on holiday and left the house empty while it was for sale. Now, somebody broke into the house, changed all the locks, and rented it out to somebody else, and it wasn't even their house. And it took 7 months and $7,500 for them to get their house back off this person. And I was like, wow, the cheek and the audacity of some people in this country is just unreal. It really is. You know, imagine just like putting your house up for sale and somebody breaking in, changing the locks and renting it out to a complete stranger. And you couldn't do a thing about it. Oh, I'd be fuming. I'd have burnt the house down with the bastards in it. I would. I wouldn't let anyone take my house. My house is my kingdom. My shrimp is definitely sulking tonight. Let's turn you around a bit. Can you see him? He's like lying there. He's really sulking. Don't know why. I've actually got a pond that I'm going to be setting up in the house, and I won't be putting koi in it. I'm going to be getting Fatty back from the fish shop. She's actually been there since September, and they keep saying to me, psych, when are you coming to get this fish? You know, we could have sold this fish like 3-4 times over. So yeah, I am really going to have to get her. Dave says, sad day today, all my fish, corals and tank have gone. Where have they gone? Oh, you're ready for your new upgrade, aren't you? So does that mean that you've set the new one up, or... It's like, scroll up to 6 or 7 of my messages. Pabs, come on. That's what this super chat button's for. If you want me to take note of your comments, you've got to use that super chat button. I can't be scrolling up. I'm doing something. My hands are busy. I can't scroll up. I've got the wrong glasses on. And my hands are busy. I'm trying to do a spliff and you put your viewers down. PB, can I have your clowns for free? If you're in the UK and you want to come and get them, yeah, feel free. I was actually thinking of doing that. I was actually thinking of selling everything in this tank to get a bit of fun so I can get a new light for the tank that I've got. Because I'll show you in a minute. Let me just finish doing what I'm doing and I'll show you the light and you'll understand what I mean. Yeah, everybody sub to Dave Green. Let me just do this. Hang on 1 second. It's always a sub party in my room, Dave. Always a sub party. That's the only reason I do these live streams, is so that everybody can sub to everybody else and we can all join together. It's one big happy family. Yeah, I'm rolling a spliff. Trying to. There you go. I'm definitely deleting this live stream after this. Right, the light on this tank, it's the Jewelrio 240. And it's got this light with it. Now, I've never used one of these before. I know it's upside down, but I can't turn it around. But I don't like it. It's got 2 bulbs on the inside, one's pink and one's white. So I'm going to take that light off, I'm going to take the lid off, and I'm going to do a custom type lid with my own light in it. until I can save up and afford some kettles, that is, which will be about a year. So yeah, I don't know, maybe I will sell everything in this tank and just start the new tank as fresh. I'm even considering starting it with the rock that I've got. Do you want me to show you my rock? Right, how am I best doing this? These are the pieces of rock that I've got for the new tank. So we'll just put them on here for now, show you them. I've got that one. I've got a little one with a cave in the middle. I've got this one, and look at the design on the rock. It is so. It looks like honeycomb, that's what it looks like. And that's going to go on top of there like that. And then I've got another little piece. So that can go somewhere. Hopefully it doesn't all fall and smash my side chick. But my main problem is, and you're going to laugh now, seriously, don't laugh at me. But look, I have got this. And I am not shitting you, this weighs an absolute ton. But it looks, I'll have to put it down because it's so heavy. But they're the rocks that I've got anyway, and I've been playing around with them and doing escape and changing it all around, as you do. And I still haven't come up with anything. I like that piece, I really like that piece. It's got a cave. And it is, the camera's really not doing it justice. It is just so pretty. So, the question is, I mean, that's the same, that's got like a big cave underneath. Now, most of you in this live chat will know that them rocks I actually had in my Trophius tank. And they were green and they were algaed up to death. And it took me about a month to clean them all off, get them all white again. They've been rinsed, they've been dried in the sun, they've been rinsed again, dried in the sun. And hey, I've got loads of rock going on, loads of it. So it should fill that tank very nicely. So the question is, if I'm gonna put new rock into that tank, what do I do with all this rock? Because obviously this is gonna look minging. Or do I just put it in because it's going to have filtration into it? So, yeah, that is the question. Oh, Danny's vlog says, shout out to Dolly the Frontosa. Oh, I miss Dolly. Dolly was a really nice fish. So you're saying that I should keep all this as well and add that as well as that rock? Because then that'll be, yeah, that's the filtration, won't it? That's what I was thinking of doing. Obviously, I'm not using any of this sand. I'm going to throw all that sand away. Any bristle worms or anything nasty that's in that sand is getting thrown away. It is not coming into my new tank. Definitely not. I can't wait to go and buy fish. Definitely can't wait. It's been a while since I actually bought any fish. The last fish I actually bought were my ruby red dragonets, and they died. And before that, I bought a purple firefish, and that died. So everything I've bought for this tank has died, except for my clownfish and my shrimp. They're the only three occupants of this tank that have survived out of everything that I've put in it. So, yeah. But yeah, I'm definitely starting with new sand in the system. Definitely. It's going to be, the sand bed on this tank's only about that deep. In the new tank, it's going to be about that deep. See, my screen's gone blue again. Every time I put something in front of my camera, my screen just changed. There you go. it's like click and it changes colour. I think my phone's fucked. Oh well, never mind. Time for an upgrade. I've just got a text off my daughter. She's on her way home and she's early because she's hungry. Happy 420, Tank. I read an article this morning. Thanks for bringing that up, Dave. Yeah, white wedding. I read an article this morning about weed weddings and I thought, what a fantastic idea. If I was to move anywhere, it'd be somewhere where it was legalised. Definitely. Definitely. Yeah, I agree, Danny. Your mum's cooking's definitely always the best. And my kid's favourite meal, you know what it is. It's got to be scouse. Dumplings. It takes me forever to do it, but they love it. Absolutely love it. You can't beat a nice big pan of scouse. Yeah, definitely Cali. Definitely, definitely. Oh man, it's just crazy over there. It is. I watch all these videos on YouTube and I'm like, I'm drooling. Absolutely drooling. Bacon and egg butty. Half of these are probably wondering what a butty is. Okay, they'll put it to the question, right? All my American friends in this live stream, do any of you know what a butty is? I'll give you a super huge shout out if anyone can tell me what a butty is. Yeah. Paul's Reef says he hasn't got a clue. Dave, you're English, you don't count. You're not allowed to say, and neither are you, Pabs. Look at Ren. Ren's turned upside down, he's just gonna drop now. Look, watch. He leaves a big snail trail on my tank. That's actually one of my smaller snails. I've got three of them in there, it's an Osarius snail. I've got three in there, and that's one of the smaller ones. Yeah, Pabs, like a butty boy. Come on, everybody must know what a butty is. I can't believe. Sandy, I'm going to tell you what a butty is. A butty is a sandwich. That's all it is. Don't ask me why, but in Liverpool, we call a sandwich a butty. So, yeah. Dave says that Pabs is a video maniac. Pabs, you've got to be quick to catch it. Dave, you've got to be quick to catch Pabs' videos. Honestly, you do. You've got to be really quick. Because no sooner does he post them, he deletes them. Only because he's scared that his wife will see them. And she'd kill him. She would. She'd absolutely kill him. I'm actually quite hungry myself now. It's going to be a pizza, I think. It's definitely going to be a pizza. I'm in the mood for a pizza. My clowns have been very slow tonight. Does anybody know in here how to... I watched a video a while ago about green star polyps and how to frag them, and I can't remember who it was who did the video. So does anybody know if there's any videos out there on how to frag GPS? GSP, yeah, GSP, that's the one. Because I need to frag it. It's growing like crazy. It's like, it's growing on that rock, this rock, and that rock. It's growing on four of the rocks. So when it comes to me moving, I'm not going to be able to move them rocks. So I need to find a way of doing it without killing it. Paul's Reef, you can usually scrape them off the rock and then use a razor to cut the mat. Ah, right, okay, so that sounds pretty easy, actually. I might just Google it and see if I can come up with any videos that anybody's done, and I could just copy what they've done. But I have noticed, if I lift this rock here, it does lift away from the other rock. So if I can cut it like down the middle, it should be okay, shouldn't it? So they're pretty simple to do and they heal quickly. Cool, thank you very much. Appreciate it. Battery's gonna die any sec, says Danny. Well, plug your charger in. Trim it back and frag what you remove. Right, okay, cool, Sandy. Got it. Super Yellow Tank says he uses scissors to cut his or it should just peel off. Right, cool. I'll give both of them a go. GSP fragging by Dave. How can I copy that link from here? Dave, oh, you can't see the comment section below, can you? I don't know. You probably have to wait until this video is uploaded and then you can post it in the comment section. Or you could post it on one of my previous videos and I'll find it that way. Oh, there's plenty of them. Alright, cool. I'll find them. I'll use my searching powers. My daughter's just come in. I've just heard the front door slam. Yeah, I'm going to do my tank kind of different. Because I don't know if I want loads of fish. And I don't know if I want loads of coral. I don't know. I want something really different. Really unusual. I'm going to try my hand at making it look as different as possible. Because I've noticed a lot of the reef tanks, they all kind of look the same. So I'm going to try and make it unique. Yeah, I'm going to do it psych style. I'm not going to rush it. I'm not going to rush it at all. Definitely not going to rush it. And then, I've seen that Gobi Jake video by that you said before, Dave. That was hilarious. That was the best video I've seen in ages. It really was. Because every time that Gobi was spitting it out, he was spitting it back in. And I just thought that is just absolutely classic. And it's actually convinced me to make my sand bed in the new tank at least 3-4 inches deep. Because I am going to invest in some of them sand gobies, definitely. So, yeah. I'm trying to keep up with the comments. There's just so many of them. My clowns are acting really strange. Can you see them? They're not doing their usual darting around. I think they're full off their legs. Yeah, if anybody hasn't seen the video, Dave's just put a link up there. Make sure you go and check it out. It is absolutely brilliant video. Brilliant video. I think it was funny the way they were giggling in the background. Sykes, how much will it cost in salt for your new tank? For everything that I need. The only thing I need to buy for it is a new light. I can get a new light for about £100. I've got the Mars Aqua light on this one, so they're about £80. So I reckon I could sell that for about £40. And I reckon I could sell a few other things that I've got lying around and make it up to the £100. So before long, I'll have the light that I want. I just try and sell everything that I've got to get more, if you get what I mean. Hey, Armando. Yeah, cool. Thank you very much for joining the live stream. I hope you've enjoyed it and I will speak to you soon. How much will the salt cost me? Oh, you mean me salt water? Well, each one of them costs me a fiver, and that's 25 litres in each of them. And it's 240 litre tank. So you're making me do maths now. So that's 25, that's 50, that's 100. So two of them, that's 8. So I'm going to need 10 of them, so £50. It's going to cost me £50 in water. Yeah, about £50. About 50, 60 quid in water. That's just to fill it. It's not going to be cheap. I know that much. Oh, it's always the way, isn't it? I better get in and on this YouTube channel, hadn't I? I get it delivered. Somebody actually delivers it for me, so that actually saves me quite a bit of money. I did buy it from the fish shop, but it was really, really shit quality that I was buying. And that was why I was having all the algae issues that I was having. But the guy who delivers it, he's really nice. He's got a saltwater tank himself, so every time I've got an issue with my tank, I usually see him first. But yeah, he's a cool guy. Very cool. But that will all end on May the 8th because I will be getting an RODI system. I'll be doing my own water and hopefully start selling my own water because there's nobody in this area that sells salt water. So it just makes sense that if I get a 55-gallon RODI system that I'll just start selling my own water. The house I'm moving to doesn't have a water meter, so I don't have to worry about anything like that. So why not? Yeah, I'm looking forward to mixing my own salt water, actually, perhaps, because I've watched a lot of videos and I understand the concept of it, and it's just going to be so much easier. Like, now I have to monitor my water changes, and I suppose it keeps it into a strict routine, but, you know, if something is to go wrong in the middle of the line, like now, for instance, if you look at my water, one's RODI and two are salt, two piled on their own as salt. So if I have an accident in my tank tonight and something happens and I have to do a water change, I can't do one because I haven't got the water to do it with. So it's like a big mag rush in the morning. I have to phone him, get him to drop me water off, and it is a bit of an annoying situation. Fingers crossed I haven't had any mishaps. Buy some digital scales, they are called the digital balance. What do I need digital scales for? You're confusing me now, Pabs. Totally confusing me. So, Major's asleep, and I suppose he needs feeding. I don't have a clue what time is it. What time is it? Somebody tell me what time is it. Oh, to weigh out my salt. Oh, right, it's like, yeah, I know, yeah, I've got, I've got, scales to do all that with. Yeah, that's cool. Yeah, I've got everything that I need. How cool. Dave Green said his bio home got delivered today. It's 10:30, it's not 10:30. It might be 10:30 where you live, Yellow Tank. Pabs, what time is it? And don't lie to me. If it's 10:30, I seriously have to go, because that means I've been sat here for 2.5 hours. But my clock only says 67 minutes. I'm in Iran and it's 3 a.m. Pabs, stop it. Okay, I started this at 8 o'clock. I've been on here for, it's about 9. It's about 10 past 9, isn't it? Oh, you're all burning my head out now. Proper burning my head out. It's 9 o'clock, Dave. Thank you. Thank you. At last, someone normal in my live stream. I'm an Iraq moustache. Right, well, I am going to cut this stream off in a minute because I'm going to go and have some pizza because I am starving. And I'll probably jump into Rico's stream because no doubt he's got a stream going somewhere, he always has. So anybody in here who isn't subbed to Rico's Reef Tank, make sure you go and sub his channel up and go and join his live stream, because that's where I will be in about 5 minutes once I've tidied all my mess away and tear my fish off. And I tell you what does annoy me, that iPhone does not allow us to do anything with blue lights. Because when I turn this off and the tank is in blue, it looks absolutely fantastic. It does. I'm glad you all enjoyed it. I enjoy sitting here and talking to you all. I do. I feel it's more on a personal level. So, yeah, I do really enjoy it. So, thank you, thank you, thank you to everybody who's joined. I'm glad you've enjoyed it. I won't be doing a live stream tomorrow night because Aaron's Aquariums usually goes live at about 9 o'clock. So I will be back on Saturday evening, and hopefully I will have something planned, because I've got two people sending me something interesting in the post. One, I know what it is. Two, of the other person, I don't know what it is, but I will do a live unboxing, okay? And I promise I will be in the video, because you're going to have to see the reaction on my face when I open this off this person, because it's going to be fun. It is. It's going to be fun. So stay tuned for Saturday night. We'll be here having fun in my live stream. Pabs. Like I said, it's going to be live. It's going to be here. If you want to know what I'm unboxing, make sure you're here on Saturday night. Watch Britain's Got Talent. I am on it, Dave Green. Dave, seriously, are you on Britain's Got Talent? Because I never, ever, ever watch that programme. But if you're on it, I will definitely watch it. When is it on? I'll even record it. Definitely, definitely. Right, so anyway, enough of that. I will see you all on Saturday night. Have a great evening. Nice start to the weekend. I love you all. Thanks for watching. Bye.